Okay, so thanks for joining us today. We're here today at the Purina Animal Nutrition Center to talk chicken. I'm Patrick Biggs, flock nutritionist for Purina, and with me today are AJ and Gretchen. So why don't you introduce yourself
sure.
to our audience?
I'm AJ Lee. I'm the assistant manager here at the companion unit at the Purina Animal Nutrition Center. I take care of the backyard flock and all the chickens we have here on the farm.
And Gretchen?
My name is Gretchen Riley, and I am a customer relations manager here at Purina Animal Nutrition Center, and I help to manage actually all of the companion-related events that happen here at the farm.
All right. And for those of you out there, be sure to let us know where you're watching from. Post down there in the comments. If you have any questions for us, post those down there in the well, and we'll get to those here in a little bit. So. We're here today on this beautiful day in Missouri with our chickens. We're celebrating Flocktober because it's that time of year. We're celebrating farm fresh eggs and backyard hens. With eggs, the celebration begins in September. A lot of our audience out there has started their chickens in the spring. Now they're approaching that time where they're starting to lay eggs here in September towards the end of October. So. One of the things that I know our audience is very happy about are the coop signs. Most of you are familiar with their signs, but if you're not, we had a big reveal last week that many of you saw. And so here we have some of our signs now. So we have here, AJ's holding the red sign, is spoiled hens make better eggs. I've got the orange sign of breakfast laid daily, and Gretchen is holding keep calm and cluck on. So for those of you out there, vote. Let us know which one of these signs is your favorite. We've got the red, orange, and blue. Just post those down in the comments. All right. Okay. So these signs are the third edition of the Purina Collectibles signs. During Flocktober, you'll be able to get those free when you purchase a bag of Purina layer feed at your participating feed stores. All right. So again, we're here at the Purina Animal Nutrition Center in Missouri with our hens. And I've got AJ and Gretchen, and I'm Patrick here. Don't forget, do we have anybody listening to us? I forgot to introduce our lovely assistant behind the camera who's keeping track of who's joining us, Lori.
Hi.
She's going to be telling us. Who's joined us, Lori?
Rebecca Davis, Darlene Ryan, Hubert Tina.
All right, Rebecca. All right, that's great.
Awesome. Do a shout out from what parts of the country you're from. It's kind of interesting to see.
Yeah, tell us where you're listening from and watching from. All right. So, while she's doing that and while you guys are posting some of those things, let's get back to Flocktober.
Sure.
The big part about celebrating Flocktober is reminiscing about your first egg. So, for those of you out there, feel free to tell us what your first egg story is in the comments below, and maybe we'll get to share some of those as well. But I think before we get to those, we should probably share our own first egg stories with the audience. So I think I'll start. Oh, unless you want to.
No, go.
All right. I'll go first. So I've never actually had chickens of my own. Like growing up, I wasn't a farm kid. So my first exposure to chickens was actually in college. I was in a poultry science class. We had chickens there. We were learning a little bit about the anatomy and so on and so forth. And so we had to go out and we had to pick the chicken up and we had to hold the chicken. So I'm standing there holding this chicken in this lab while the professor's walking around and kind of talking about the different aspects of the chicken. And next thing I know, she's starting to make these funky noises. And next thing I know, there's an egg coming out of the back end of her. So while I'm holding her, she lays an egg in my hand. And so from there, I guess I was destined to be a poultry nutritionist from there. So, AJ, what about you? What's your story?
I probably can't remember my very, very first egg because I've had chickens my entire life, as far as I can remember at least. But here at the farm, I was here when we first introduced backyard chickens to the research center. And so we've got 12 coops here. Each of them have about 15 chickens in them. So I remember we put a lot of preparation and hard work into getting these coops set up. And whenever we first got that very first egg, it was a really exciting experience for all of us here because, we had launched into the backyard chicken thing, and it was an exciting day, I guess. I think I remember getting texts with pictures of eggs because everybody was excited that we were finally laying eggs here.
All right. And now Gretchen is actually one of our best customers because she has a wide variety of animals. Horses, dogs, cats, and chickens.
And of course chickens.
And of course chickens, otherwise you wouldn't be standing here. But can you tell us a little bit about, you remember your first egg?
Well,
or what's your first egg story?
So, I don't know if I'm a good chicken mom or not, but I've had hens now since 2014, so I guess, so this is my fourth year of having new chickens. And every year was always exciting because I did the countdown in weeks and kind of the day of expecting when I'm supposed to get the eggs to finally show up, and it was exciting every single year. And I have seven new girls. How many chickens do I have? I only have 17. You'd think I should count them.
It's chicken math. She doesn't know.
I don't know anymore, which is kind of sad, but that's what happens, right? Chicken math is great. So I have 7 new girls, and I did this year remember that I took a picture of the first egg compared to one of my adult hen eggs, yeah, and posted it on Facebook and said they're finally laying eggs, and they were about right at about 18 weeks old, yeah, when I did that. But I brought show and tell.
Oh, show and tell. All right.
And all right. I thought
she's a proud chicken parent.
I'm a proud, right, chicken mommy. That's because, right, my 7 girls are still laying little eggs, but. So AJ,
oh, yes,
I don't know, you can tell the story about, yeah, that little guy.
Yeah, this is actually one of the eggs that was laid here. So
yeah,
what you have, this is an adult-sized chicken. That's the regular-sized chicken egg. And then, well, here, look at that. Very first egg, look how tiny that is. Now, that's not uncommon, that happens. You know, they're very eager to provide you with eggs, and sometimes they aren't quite ready to lay you a full-size egg, but don't worry, give them a few days, maybe a week or so, they'll get there.
Yeah,
but let's see some of yours.
Well, so that's one of the little,
yep,
baby ones.
I think we often call these peewees in the commercial industry. Those would probably be,
okay,
peewees.
And so I just use 2 eggs,
yep,
when they call for 1 egg.
Right. They're still got the same thing. They're still yolk and white and everything. Yes. And you can still eat them. There's nothing wrong. They're just tiny.
They're just baby.
They're diet eggs.
Oh, good. All right. Good way to look at it.
They'll get there. They'll get there. They get the nice. I see you got some nice green ones. You got some.
Yep. I have some Easter eggers.
Easter eggers. All,
yep,
right.
So
those are very pretty eggs.
Yes, they are very pretty. The hens are a little bit nondescript.
Yeah.
But I love my girls, and they lay really pretty, right, eggs. So.
And that's the nice thing, too, about having chickens all the time is, right, you know, you don't have to just celebrate the first egg from your very first flock. Every year, if you add new birds, every year you get to celebrate the first egg.
I know. I see what kind of polka dots you get on them. This is a brown egg, but it's,
yeah,
got little speckles on it.
Yeah. And so, what breed? Do you remember what breed the first egg here at the farm was from?
So whenever we first started out, we had some Easter eggers, actually, and we actually had, I guess we had some Barred Rocks and Rhode Island Reds.
Okay.
But I'm pretty sure the first one was from either the Barred Rock or the Rhode Island Red.
Okay.
Easter eggers were a little bit,
yeah,
slacking.
They were, yeah, slacking. So my first egg actually came from a white legger.
Okay.
Mine was from a commercial bird. Do you have any idea on yours?
Well,
I had
3 hens,
okay,
the first year. One was a Barred Rock, one was an Easter egger, and one was a Buff Orpington.
Did you name your hens?
Yes.
Oh, well.
Roxanne, Buffy, and April.
Oh, there you go. That's right.
Guess which one is which? The Buff Orpington was named Buffy.
Oh.
Is named Buffy.
Yes.
She's a little strong.
All right. That's great. All right. Lori, do we have a...
We have people joining us from San Diego, North Carolina, Southern Maryland,
all
Dallas,
right,
Texas.
All over the
all
place.
Over.
All, awesome, over.
That's great.
Cool.
All right. Did anybody share a first egg story with us?
No first egg story.
Oh, all right. Well,
any questions or anything yet?
Rebecca Davis, she wants to know, when will my chickens start laying eggs?
That's a great question. So, you know, first eggs usually around 18 to 20 weeks. It depends on the breed. It could happen around 16 weeks on some, but it fluctuates. Around 18 weeks is when we say we make that transition from a starter feed to a layer feed. While Lori's getting some more questions and figuring out everything else, let's talk a little bit more about what's going on here at the farm.
Sure.
What kind of birds do we have here, AJ?
So like I said earlier, we've got 12 coops right here. They're all populated with Barred Rock hens. So each of them have about 15 birds in there. But yeah, we try to keep everything consistent because we're doing research here on the farm, so we want to keep everything the same breed.
That's great. And then, you know, like we said, 18 to 20 weeks is when they start laying,
yes,
eggs. So, Gretchen, you know, since you have your own flock, is there anything that you notice about those birds that kind of maybe some behavior changes when it comes about time for them to start laying eggs? Or is there anything you notice that they're doing at that time?
Well, you know, physically, obviously, they're getting bigger and mature. And so
yeah.
They're starting starting to look like my older hens, and so I figure age-wise they're getting close, and I do a little countdown on my calendar for that 18 to 20 weeks, because it is exciting to have your babies get their first egg. But, you know, they're a little bit more curious. I can see them kind of checking out the coop and going in and out of the nest boxes and trying to figure out what they are.
Nest boxes, let's keep those nest boxes closed until probably about 16 weeks old. We don't want them going in there too early and kind of deciding that that's the place to go hang out. But if we wait till about 16 weeks, 18 weeks, that's where you can kind of open up, because then they'll get in and get out and lay their eggs. Some other things that you might notice about them if you're really paying attention is their combs and wattles are going to start to change. They're going to start getting larger in size. And when they actually do start laying eggs, they're going to have a deeper red color to them. And so,
I didn't pay attention to that. Right. So well, good to know.
Well, it's something something to look forward to, because maybe you didn't know.
Yeah.
And then you'll also tell as they get older and it comes time to maybe molt, you'll also notice as they stop laying eggs, their combs and wattles will start to regress a little bit. They'll actually get paler in color. So that's kind of an easy way
learn
to tell
something new every
if
day.
If your chicken's laying eggs or not.
Yeah. Right. But if you have a group of chickens, kind of pick out maybe who's the slacker.
Right. Who's just eating the feed for free?
Yeah, who's just eating the feed?
That's right.
Not making breakfast late.
Yeah, that's right. Right. They are following the sign.
Hey, do we have any votes on the signs yet? Blue, red, or orange?
We have all three. We have all. They're pretty neck and neck.
Well, I guess we did ask the audience for suggestions for these signs. So I think these actually came from
some of our
fans. Alright, so let's talk about what do we feed these birds. Adrian, what do we feed the birds out here at the farm?
So everybody out here at the farm is on Laena, of course.
Okay. Alright, and then we did mention to make sure that you're switching over your birds to a layer feed around 18 weeks old, or whenever you start seeing eggs. If you start seeing eggs, that's when it's also a sign to switch your hens over. But if they're taking their time and they're starting to loaf around and not lay eggs, 18 weeks is when we're going to suggest you make that transition. And then, we talk about making that transition. So Gretchen, maybe you can share with us and our audience kind of how you make that transition from your starter feed to your layer feed.
Yeah. So I know the ideal way to introduce a new feed is to do it gradually, a little bit of the new as they eat through the old product. So I thought that maybe it would work well if I had the starter crumbles in my feeder. And as that level dropped down, I would just add a little bit of the layer pellets on top, and they would kind of work into the starter crumbles, and it seemed to work pretty well.
Yeah.
And I tried to pay attention to make sure that all the layer pellets weren't dumped out there at once, but they seemed to transition well.
Yeah.
But I do have a question for you quick as it relates to switching from a starter to a layer. Is there anything about introducing a layer feed that helps to jumpstart their laying? Or it's just supporting the laying activity?
Right, so the one thing you could do if you want to be a little more proactive in kind of giving your hens the extra nutrition they need to kind of convince their bodies that they should start laying eggs. So around 16 weeks old is when you can start making your transition from the starter to the layer feed. And so that little extra boost of calcium that they're going to get from the layer feed is going to kind of help build up their body stores, so when they do get those eggs, the shells are going
to
be nice and strong, and the hens are going
to
be ready to go, and you'll have a little less issues with the egg abnormalities and our soft shells, things of that nature.
Good to know. Question?
Yes, we have a couple viewers asking, how do they get the signs?
How do they get the signs? All right, so you're going to go to your local feed dealer. It needs to be a Purina dealer. Unfortunately, the Tractor Supply stores don't have these, but I think for every bag of feed, or when you make a purchase of layer feed, you can get one of these signs. So you'll have to get there. I know they go pretty fast because everybody's out there getting these and supplies are somewhat limited. So get out there and get your signs.
I'm excited. I'm due for some Laena Omega, so I hope to go get my sign.
Yes. All right. Oh, and the one thing. So you mentioned that you feed your hens pellets.
Yes.
All right. Have you ever tried the layer crumbles?
I have, and I can tell you my personal choice of crumbles over or pellets over crumbles.
Okay.
I feel like they don't waste the pellets quite as much because they can actually see them on the ground if they get knocked out, and so they really do clean up around the feeder. And I really noticed they kind of made a mess with the crumbles, so I went back to pellets on my dinner.
Yeah, chickens are kind of like bulldozers when it comes to getting their food out of the feeder. They just kind of sit in and they just kind of scoop out. So pellets tend to make a little waste. The nutrition in both the pellet and the crumble, it's the same. It's just the particle size. You know, some chickens and some owners have a preference as to what they feel that their chickens prefer. So there's really not any big, I guess.
There's no nutritional difference.
There's no nutritional difference.
Personal choice in your
And like you said, there's probably going to be a little less waste with the pelleted feed than with the crumbles.
That's the same here at the farm. We put everything on pellets just to try to avoid the mess that it makes.
Right.
The one thing that does drive my decision is I do want to feed the Lane Omega, and that does come in a pellet. So.
Yeah, right. Okay. So again, we're here at the Purina Animal Nutrition Center with our hens. I've got AJ and Gretchen with me. I'm Patrick Biggs, the flock nutritionist here. Feel free to post down there in the comments who you are, where you're from, and if you have any questions about chickens, and go ahead and post them there, and our behind-the-camera operator will shout those out to us. So, Lori, our behind-the-camera operator, do we have any questions?
I have a couple. Back to the signs. Where can I find a list of dealers? And second, Stacy would like to know, should you add fake eggs to promote laying? And Sandy Husky would like to know, what is the best bedding to use?
All right. You're assuming I'm going to remember all of those questions.
Well, yes.
All right.
That's why
Lori wrote them down. All right.
To find a dealer.
So to find a dealer, if you go out to the PurinaMills.com webpage, there's a dealer locator there. You can type in your zip code, and then that'll kind of tell you what dealers are in your area. If you're really after one of these signs, I would suggest probably calling ahead and making sure that they have them before you make the drive, because sometimes those dealers aren't always that close. Before you make that 20-30 minute drive out there, make sure they have one for you. All right, so then the next question was about fake eggs in the nest to kind of encourage egg production. I would hesitate to do that, because a lot of times if we put eggs in the nest like that, that might convince somebody who decides they want to be broody and is going to teach them that they can go in the nest box and sit there and not lay eggs. So if they're sitting on the eggs, they're not actually laying eggs. So if you want your chickens to keep laying eggs, you want them to not be sitting on the eggs. So encouraging them to spend more time in the nest boxes is probably the best thing to do. And then the last one was
about bedding.
Bedding. All right, bedding material. So we use pine shavings here at the farm. That's typically what gets used most often in our coop areas. Now, you'll notice, I don't know if you can see in our run areas, but we actually have gravel in our run area. So we don't recommend putting any sort of bedding material in your run area. We do this to help with kind of some maintenance and keep things a little cleaner around here.
More sanitary,
but so at your own home, like Gretchen, you probably don't have gravel. You have what, grass? Do you have them just kind of in a grassy area?
Well, I use pine shavings in the coop, and then I do let them wander around a little bit. So it's the gravel driveway and the lawn.
Right. So in your run area, that's where they're going to spend most of their time. So they're going to dig and they're going to scratch and they're going to make a dust bath. So anything you put in there, they're going to dig down until they find dirt. Right. Anyways, even here in our gravel, they'll shove the gravel out of the way.
Yeah, they burrow and make holes and try to dust bathe.
Right. So, we don't recommend putting any bedding material in there. But in the coops where you have your eggs, you want to try and keep things cleaner. And that's where we put all of our pine shavings. Some people recommend sand. You can use sand. It's a little easier to keep clean. It helps drain things. If you're going to use it, use a construction grade sand. It's a little coarser material. We don't want to use play sand because that's too fine, so the water doesn't settle through it. And so then you can kind of treat that almost like kitty litter, where you can kind of scoop out the dirty spots and then just spot check it every now and then. You don't have to clean that out nearly as often as you do with pine shavings. But and then stay away from things like hay and straw. Those can harbor some molds and mildews and other things and cause some respiratory issues. All right. Who else is with us? Do we have anybody?
Jeff.
He just joined. We have a viewer from Peoria, Arizona. One from Alabama.
All right. All right. So while we're waiting for our audience to participate,
I have a viewer question.
Oh, we have a viewer question. All right.
Courtney Rutherford, is it safe for a rooster to eat layer feed?
All right. Courtney, it's like you're reading my cards. I appreciate that, Courtney. So, you know, one of the things, you know, we have a lot of questions that people get, and that's one of our common questions that people always ask. You know, it kind of goes along with, do I need a rooster to lay eggs? And we don't need roosters to lay eggs. But a lot of people keep roosters there because, you know, it helps with protection of the hens, with the flock. You know, especially if you let your hens free range, the rooster will be out there and kind of be there. Last line of defense if some predator comes along, but then it's always, how do I feed that rooster? Because really your rooster shouldn't be eating layer feed. There's a lot of extra calcium in layer feed that's not good for him. He's got to get rid of that, and it's kind of hard on his kidney. So if he's eating layer feed all the time, it's going to probably shorten his lifespan. It's not going to kill him right away, but over a long period of time, it's just going to shorten his lifespan. So then, you know, we talk about feeding them separately, then the next question after that is, you know, how do you go about doing that? And so that gets a little trickier. One of my favorite things to do is to provide a second feeder for him. You can actually, you know, put it like on the side of the run, because the roosters tend to be a little larger than the hens, so you can put it up a little higher and he'll be the one that eats in there. So something like Purina Flock Raiser is a great thing to feed the rooster, and he'll do just fine on that. If that gets a little too complicated, you know, your other option is to feed all of your flock Purina Flock Raiser and then provide supplemental oyster shell to those hens. That way the ladies can get the calcium they need to lay their eggs. All right. You mentioned you brought some of your eggs, and we talked about the smaller sized eggs. One of the things that you're going to actually see a lot of abnormalities in your eggs. And so as you have your chickens, you know, everyone's used to going to the store and opening up their carton of eggs, and they all look nice and uniform. They all look the same. And that's because there are machines at the commercial farms that kind of, all of those kind of oddly shaped eggs, if you got one that's kind of long and skinny, or you got one that's got a lot of extra stuff on it, or it's not pointed, you know, the end is pointed a little sharper than, it's not quite so round, or, you know, you start getting your peewees in there, you know, they all shuttle those off somewhere else, so you don't actually see all those things. So even the commercial birds are laying all of these kind of the abnormal eggs that you see. They just don't make it from the farm to the grocery store.
So I know here at the farm, it seems like we get more abnormal eggs in the beginning, like a young birds have more abnormal eggs.
Right. So you're going to see that more because, you know, like most teenagers, as their hormones are kind of fighting and trying to figure out how they come into balance, they're all over the place. They know they need to be laying eggs, but their hormones haven't quite balanced themselves out to get that right blend to get a normal size egg. So they're just waiting for that period for the whole body to kind of come in tune, kind of in sync, so that the hormones and the whole egg production side of them is like. So once they come into production, probably within 2 to 3 weeks, you'll see the majority of your kind of abnormal eggs. And then after that, they'll start to be more uniform.
Another quick question is, if you do let your birds free range a fair amount, or kind of out where they can get another food source, how much negative effect would that have on especially a young bird that's just starting to lay eggs?
It's hard to say because we don't really know exactly what they're eating. So if you are going to let your birds kind of wander and free range and kind of forage for themselves out in your yard, it's always best to make sure that when they come back at night to have, you know, their complete feed, like laying in there, that's going to have all of the nutrition that they need so that they can support what they're finding out in your run area.
Is it best to just really limit their time outside, like give them an hour or two to be outside and then back in?
I don't know. I mean, I guess it depends on how much stuff is in your area for them to eat. You know, if there's if they're just kind of a grassy area, there's not a lot for them to really get into, then, you know, if they're probably not going to find too much. But if they have, if you have a garden area that they can get into, or if you have a lot of bushes and shrubs and or a lot of mulch area, if you have a lot of mulch, there's a lot of bugs and stuff that get in that mulch, and so the hens are going to love that because they're going to get in there and dig through that and see what they can find.
Yeah.
It's really hard to say what they get because, you know, no one's keeping track of what they're actually finding. So chances are they're not eating enough out there to really have a big negative impact on their egg production. But as long as, I think as long as you're supplementing them with the somebody's some noises in the background.
Yeah, somebody just laid an egg or something.
But as long as you're providing them with a layer feed to come back to, then you should be fine.
Be fine.
Yep. Lori, anything else?
No, just a couple quick shout-outs. Diane Broderick, Travis Leal, Sheila, Gretchen Gouda.
Hey,
another Gretchen. Team Gretchen.
Yay!
All right. So, you know, I guess thanks everyone out there for joining us. You know, remember, run out to your feed dealers, and as you buy a bag of feed, you can pick up one of these lovely signs. You can get your chickens, your eggs laid daily, your breakfast laid daily. You keep calm and cluck on, and well, we all know spoiled hens make better eggs.
Well, yeah,
you don't spoil your hens, do you?
Oh, no.
Of course not. So.
No, they don't all have names or anything like that.
So again, thanks for joining us here as we celebrate Flocktober, and we celebrate, you know, having first eggs. You know, stay tuned to the Purina Poultry page for fun activities that we're gonna have out there. And like I said, be sure to get out there and get your coop signs.
Yeah.
All right.
Bye.
Until then, we will see you next time. Thanks for joining us.
All right. Thanks.
Thanks.